the Eurasian back, a weapon that has been known for its legendary uselessness since its introduction in 2009. But this is really that bad, or does it have some sort of hidden usefulness that the community was unable to discover for a long time? Let's find out. Let's start off with the statistics. With equipping the Razorback, snipers grant themselves the ability to block a single backstab. When you finally found a spy who was stupid enough to backstab you, the shield will break and electrocute the poor spy for 2 seconds. This means that the spy can't attack or switch weapons during that period. The Razorback can be restored by going back to spawn. This weapon has officially no downsides. How the Razorback performs in combination with the most dangerous boomstick in the whole game, the sniper rifle? Well, the advantage of being able to block one backstab is pretty nice. It makes that you have to worry less about being backstabbed and gives you the feeling like you are just a little bit more protected. It also lets you worry less about your own personal safety and enables you to focus more on getting those headshots. The Razorback is especially annoying for spies that are wielding the Eternal Reward, since they can't easily use the sniper as an easy way to get a disguise. However, the disadvantages are, sadly enough, devastating for this weapon. That is, when you pair it up with the regular Bushman playstyle. The exact same feeling that gives you the idea that you have to worry less about your own personal safety and more about getting those headshots is actually very, very deceptive. Spies not only have a knife, they also have a gun. And with the stock revolver, it takes about 4 shots to kill you. Considering the shooting speed of the revolver, this basically means that by the time you turn around to make Vegemite out of him, he already made Ratatouille out of you, ready to be served. The only way to counter this is to start using the sniper rifle at a much smaller distance. By doing this, you make it a lot harder for enemy spies to shoot you without getting noticed by your other teammates. But this does not go without sacrifice. You can clearly notice that the sniper rifle is mainly designed for being good at big distances because you will be very often confronted with the problem of an obstructed view. Mainly caused by other teammates, smoke effects, explosions or angry people that move super fast and want to kill you. Well, what about pairing this piece of original aboriginal art with one of the most devastating ranged weapons of all time, the bow? Well, this is the point where it gets more interesting, considering you are at the range where the Luxman shines most. While the Razorback may be considered close to worthless when you are alone on the roof, this weapon certainly knows its uses a lot more when you are pushing together with a group that consists out of multiple classes. I have to admit that it feels a bit weird at first when you are suddenly standing right in the heat of battle instead of observing it. I also have to admit that once you are more familiar with the different playstyle, the Razorback comes in completely different. You don't have the idea that you are safer since it is countered by the fact that you are standing right in front of the enemy team together with your teammates. The difference here between the Huntsman and the Sniper Rifle is that teammates, smoke effects and explosions don't bother you that much anymore, because you have a much better feel of what exactly is going on. This is also the point where the Razorback gets a psychological value against spies. Sure, enemy spies can still attack you, but they have to accept the fact that they will be targeted and most likely die. Backstabbing you is for spies like signing their death contract. It also works very well when you swarm a bit around friendly buildings, like sentries or dispensers. No way a spy is going to backstab you when you are standing right next to a beeping sentry. Especially when the sentry has 2 miniguns and a rocket launcher ready to unload and with thirst for blood grows bigger and bigger with every beep it emits. After all the time I spent with the Razorback, I still feel like I was missing my SMG on a regular basis. Especially in situations where suddenly an enemy showed up. Maybe it's just me for not being able to aim well with the Huntsman or Sniper Rifle while I'm panicking at the same time, because someone is ready to squash, roast or chop me in a million little pieces. I very often felt like the SMG was the weapon I should have been having, because it enables me to spray in my enemy's general direction and hopefully get a kill. After a lot of thought and time with the Razorback, I still feel like this weapon should have a minor buff. Something that pushes the players more to pair this up with the Huntsman and use a different playstyle. I feel like the Razorback doesn't fertilize the playstyle that it needs enough and causes too many people to throw it away and never look to it again. And that is the answer on the question of this weapon is any good. It all depends how you play. Sniper rifle or huntsman doesn't matter, but using close to medium range is very much advised. I promise you that once you get used to the different playstyle, the Razorback will show its hidden beauty. Well, that concludes today's video. What is your opinion about the Razorback? Do you use it, and if so, with what kind of playstyle? What weapon would you like to have reviewed in the future? Make sure to leave your reaction down in the comment section. Also, don't shy away to give me points for improvement and make sure to subscribe and like the video if you liked it. Give the Razorback a second chance and I hope to see you all on the battlefield. Bye bye.